हेलो नमस्कार, खुश रहो बच्चों। आई एम जेवियन डॉक्टर शाहनवाज आलम, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट सम मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट कंसेप्ट ऑफ रिसर्च मेथोडोलॉजी। टुडे टॉपिक इज क्लस्टर रैंडम सैंपलिंग। द प्रॉब्लम विथ रैंडम सैंपलिंग मेथड व्हेन वी हैव टू सैंपल ए पॉपुलेशन दैट dispersed across a wide geographic region is that you will have to cover a lot of ground. Geographically, in order to get to each of the unit you sample, imagine taking a sample, a random sample of all the resident of New York State in order to conduct personal interview. By the luck of the draw, we will wind up the respondent who come from all over the state. Your interviewer are going to have a lot of traveling. It is the precise the problem that cluster or area random sampling was invented. In cluster sampling, that means area-wise sampling, we flow these steps, divide population into clusters easily along the geographical boundary. Random sample cluster measure all units within sample clusters. For instance, in the figure, we see a map. The country of New York State tells us that we have to do a survey of town government that will require us going to town personally. If we do simple random samples statewide, we have to cover the entire state geographically. Instead, we decide to do cluster sampling of 5 countries, making red in the figure. Once these are selected, we go to every town, generating 5 areas. Clearly, this strategy will help us to economize on our mileage. Cluster or area sampling then is useful in situations like this and done primarily for efficiency of administrations. Note also that we probably don't have to worry about using the approach if we are conducting a mail or telephone survey, because it doesn't matter as much where we call or send letter to. Thank you. In next topic, we will discuss about multi-stage sampling. Thank you.